the last few months, a quote, unusual comet has produced dramatic and unexpected activity that has puzzled astronomers. The comet 12P Pons-Brooks has been dubbed in science media the quote, Devil Comet, because of its two bright tails resembling horns, as seen in this image taken at the Lowell Observatory by Dr. Teddy Carita. Since July, the enormous comet, whose nucleus is about 12.4 miles across, has produced two dramatic outbursts, most recently in October. The puzzle for astronomers is the comet's tremendous distance from the Sun. As described in an article published on ScienceAlert.com, these outbursts have been particularly interesting due to their frequency and where they occurred. One theory is that comets contain forms of ice that, when exposed for the first time to heat from the Sun, cause volatile explosions. But those explosions have typically been observed closer to the Sun, and not often. According to Carita, quote, it might happen twice in 5 years. The Pons-Brooks comet, by contrast, is exploding relatively often and confoundingly far away from the Sun. Right now, it's further off than Mars, Carita noted, where, quote, it's just not that warm. That raises the question, where is the energy coming from that powers these kinds of large outbursts? And the fact that it can apparently do so many so often. On these mysterious outbursts, Dr. Carita elaborated, in Pons-Brooks, these are really, really bright, really, really large outbursts. And this is what makes the comet so interesting to scientists. Now, my most recent Thunderbolts video addressed the increasingly problematic observations of asteroids that produce dramatic comet-like activities. I began the presentation with review of Wal Thornhill and David Talbott's remarkably successful predictions on NASA's Deep Impact mission of 2005. To those familiar with the electric comet theory, the significance of repeated, dramatic cometary outbursts at vast distances from the Sun is self-evident. However, for any newcomers, I always like to begin any discussion of comets with a brief overview of the electric universe perspective. The electric comet theory, which rejects the centuries-old and highly problematic solar nebular hypothesis, has always proposed that comets are not icy blobs that accreted or condensed at the dawn of the solar system, supposedly billions of years ago. This prediction has been vindicated by every comet mission, which have all revealed comet nuclei that are desiccated and shockingly geologically complex. Comets, as well as asteroids and meteoroids, were born far more recently, torn by electrical discharge from the surfaces of planets and moons, in a relatively recent epoch of planetary instability. The massively cratered surfaces of airless worlds are the birthmarks of these celestial bodies. Because comets are not the dirty snowballs of standard theory, they do not slowly sublime due to solar warming. Comet activity, including the production of comet jets and a cometary tail and coma, are fundamentally electrical activities, as evidenced by comet X-rays, which were not predicted by standard theorists, as well as other plasma phenomena. Water molecules and other signatures of so-called volatiles are created electrochemically and released into the cometary coma, a process similar to the one now routinely postulated in mainstream astronomical literature to be the source of water in the lunar soil. As we've outlined previously, cometary outbursts at seemingly impossible distances from the Sun, and even comets exploding at similarly vast distances, is not a new puzzle for astronomers. As far back as 1957, comet Virtanen split while inside the orbit of Saturn, well over 800 million miles from the Sun. And a similar thing happened to comet Biela-Lambert. In 1976, the comet West never approached closer than 30 million kilometers from the Sun. So when a disruption occurred and the comet split into four fragments, astronomers were shocked. Decades later, in the summer of 2000, the explosive breakup of comet Linear also provoked amazement. The event occurred well over 100 million kilometers from the Sun. Indeed, further emphasizing the depth of the mystery, Carl Sagan and Anne Druyan, authors of the book Comet, reported that 80% of comets that split do so when they are far from the Sun. In stark contrast, scientists must explain the question of why some comets pass extremely close to the Sun and yet do not disintegrate, which is obviously unexpected if comets are fluffy ice balls. An extreme example of this puzzle came in 2011, when the perihelion of the Lovejoy comet C2011W3 brought it to within 140,000 kilometers of the Sun's surface. As you can see in this video, The comet survived intact after more than 1 hour in the sun's corona. In a paper in the 1960s, astronomer Dr. Brian G. Marsden highlighted the unsolved mystery of comet fragmentation. He noted not only the problem of the fragmenting comet's distance from the sun, but also the relative velocity of their separation, far greater than could be due to solar heating. He wrote, "Although most of the comets observed to split have done so for no obvious reason, one really does require an explanation when the velocity of separation is some 20% of the velocity of the comet itself. A collision with some asteroidal object at 200 astronomical units from the sun and 100 astronomical units above the ecliptic plane, even though it would only have to happen once, is scarcely worthy of serious consideration." Carl Sagan and Andruyan found a clue to the unresolved problem of comet splitting, though perhaps without recognizing its significance. They wrote, "Splitting and jetting may be connected. At the moment Comet West split, the individual fragments brightened noticeably and propelled large quantities of dust into space in the first of some dozen bursts. The same was also true of Comet Linear in 2000. In the electric comet theory, it's clear why high-velocity jets and outbursts of dust might precede the fragmentation of a comet nucleus. Comet behavior has consistently defied simple mechanical terms because they are electrified bodies orbiting within the plasma environment of the sun. In this view, the electric field within the plasma is very low, but unlike a good metal conductor, the solar plasma is of extremely low density, and therefore its current carrying ability is limited. Comets must adjust to the changing plasma potential as they move radially toward or away from the sun. On the long, slow journey through the outer reaches of the solar system, the adjustment tends to not be difficult, but it can involve visible electrical discharge effects as the comet races through the inner solar system. The comet nucleus behaves like a capacitor, and if a discharge occurs within the capacitor, it can explode violently. This could happen as a, quote, negatively charged comet races towards the more positively charged influence of the sun, or when a comet is moving away from the sun and is directly struck by a CME, or if a comet encounters the magnetotail of a planet. The model of a discharging capacitor explains why outbursts that precede comet fragmentation are far more energetic than can possibly be explained by sublimation of ices. When we turn our attention to the sudden, seemingly inexplicable outbursts of comets, perhaps none is more significant than the 2007 extraordinary activity of Comet Holmes. Significant because of the foundational theoretical crisis it still poses to standard comet theory. In October of 07, Holmes 17P stunned astronomers around the world when it suddenly brightened by a factor of a million. In less than 24 hours, it grew from a small 17th magnitude comet to a magnitude of 2.5. So large it was easily visible to the naked eye on Earth. Holmes's coma continued expanding until by mid-November of 2007, it had become the largest object in the solar system, visibly larger than the sun. The comet's coma had grown from 28,000 kilometers to 7 million kilometers. At the time of Holmes's extraordinary display, the comet was actually moving away from the sun and therefore cooling. Among the unanswered common-sense questions posed by the enigma, how does such a gravitationally minuscule body hold in place a uniform spherical coma, 7 million kilometers in diameter? If Holmes's brightening was a result of a flare-up or explosion, as some scientists speculated, why was the ejected material not asymmetrical, as one would anticipate from an explosion? Why did the conjectured explosion not produce a variety of fragmentary sizes, instead of the extremely fine dust that was actually observed? What explosive event could have caused the comet to, quote, luminate for months, rather than the seconds typical of an explosion's luminescence? Why did the comet's gaseous, dusty spherical cloud persist for months, rather than dispersing quickly away from the comet? Holmes's spectacular brightening was reminiscent of a surprising display several years earlier from the comet Hale-Bopp. As seen in the photo on your screen, Hale-Bopp was too far from the sun for a, quote, dirty snowball to sublime, and yet it already displayed seven jets. 4 years after Hale-Bopp left the inner solar system, it was still active. It displayed a coma, a fan-shaped dust tail, and an ion tail, even though it was farther from the sun than Jupiter, Saturn, and even Uranus. The comet's tail was shrinking, but it was still about 5 times longer than the distance between the Earth and the Moon. Today, the dramatic activity of a comet such as Pons-Brooks, with its repeated outbursts while beyond the orbit of Mars, is only surprising from the perspective that comets are icy, primordial, and electrically neutral. Cometary outbursts, and even comets exploding at vast distances from the Sun, will never be adequately explained in terms of subliming ices and mechanical explosions. Again, an adequate overview of the electric comet is not possible in this video, so as always, I encourage viewers to explore the vast material available on the Thunderbolts YouTube channel, as well as the websites thunderbolts.info and Wal Thornhill's site, holoscience.com. The further one travels down this evidentiary rabbit hole, the more compelling and clear it becomes that comets are among the brightest indicators of the electrical nature of our entire universe.